discover the precise figures on electrification, please welcome the CFO of Stellantis, Richard Palmer.
Thank you, Paul. Good afternoon and good morning to everybody. Over the past 1.5 hours, my colleagues have provided you with a holistic view of Stellantis' electrification roadmap. I will now provide an overview of the key financial implications of this exciting strategy. As we have previously stated, we intend to become an LEV market leader, and as a first step, we are targeting to increase our global LEV sales in 2021 to more than 400,000 units, a threefold increase over our 2020 LEV sales. Through 2030, we plan to steadily grow our LEV mix for passenger cars in Europe from our forecast 14% in 2021 to over 70% in 2030. The target is to be 10 percentage points ahead of current industry assumptions for the overall market mix by 2030. In parallel to our strategy in Europe, we intend to quickly ramp up our U.S. LEV mix for passenger cars and light-duty trucks from 4% in 2021 to exceed market LEV forecasts by 2025 at 30% and proceeding up to over 40% by 2030. This LEV sales mix will be accomplished by the introduction of electrified options across substantially all nameplates by 2025 in both Europe and the U.S., with all nameplates offering a battery electric option by 2029 in the U.S. and by 2030 in Europe. As we've explained today, by leveraging our wide range of brands, we will offer electrified options across all price points in the market and will meet consumers' requirements with best-in-class driving ranges and capabilities. By 2025, we plan to have 55 LEV vehicles across our European and U.S. passenger vehicle portfolios, of which 40 in a BEV version and 15 in a PHEV version. It is important to note that since we are the market leader in the LCV segment in Europe, we will also have full battery electric vehicle offerings across all three LCV segments, that is small, medium, and large vans, by the end of 2021. To execute on this transition to new technologies, we expect to invest more than 30 billion euros in electrification and software development between 2021 and 2025, including equity investments in our various joint venture partnerships. We currently have or are completing six key technology joint ventures, ranging from e-powertrain and e-transmission operations to battery cell chemistry and production and digital cockpit and personalized connected services. We believe these partnerships provide us the opportunity to leverage not only our in-house competencies, but also the expertise of our partners in order to bring new technology and solutions to market more rapidly, while optimizing capital allocation to further enhance our competitiveness in the marketplace. At Stellantis, we want to invest at the highest level of efficiency. To demonstrate that commitment, we expect our overall R&D and CapEx spending over the next 5 years to continue to be about 30% more efficient than the industry average based on percentage of spend versus revenues. This means we will continue to be a leader in the industry in the efficient use of capital, while also being a leading provider of affordable mobility on a global scale. Clearly, one of the challenges in this transition is to reduce the costs of the new technology supporting the low-emission powertrains. By 2024, we intend to reduce the battery pack costs for nickel-based batteries, our high energy density offering, by more than 40% compared to 2020 levels, and then further reduce the cost by more than 20% from 2024 to  2030. One of the key contributors to these cost savings is the competencies we will have access to through our ACC joint venture partnership with TotalSaft, together with partnership arrangements with other key suppliers. Leveraging these competencies, we are implementing cost-saving actions across all the aspects of the battery pack, including battery pack optimization, simplifying the format of the battery modules, increasing the battery cell size, and upgrading the battery chemistry. To summarize the financial impacts of today's presentations, we are moving very quickly to an electrified world. Today, our margins on BEV sales in Europe are at similar levels to our internal combustion engine sales, but we have to recognize that they are supported by government incentives to customers designed to support the initial transition by consumers to these new technologies, and they are also concentrated in higher contented vehicle offerings. Looking forward, our financials will have negative impacts from our targeted increase in LEV mix due to the likely reduction or discontinuation of government incentives to customers, which will not immediately be offset by the reduction in the unit cost of the new technologies as we scale up their production volumes. Also, the increase in transaction prices necessary to offset technology costs, even if supported by reducing total cost of ownership, will potentially put downward pressure on market demand. However, in this key transition period, we are very confident that these impacts can be more than offset by the synergies we are already capturing from the formation of Stellantis, which we are confident will total 5 billion euro plus by the end of 2024, and by the roadmap for the reduction in battery costs, as well as continued optimization of other business areas, such as distribution and production costs. Stellantis will also continue to work at reducing its break-even point, driven by the target to continue to be the most capital-efficient OEM in the industry. And last but not least, the development of new revenue streams and business models, in particular related to software and connected services, will be an important lever to increase our profitability over the coming years, as well as the strong growth potential in regions like Middle East and Africa, China, Asia, and last but not least, in developing the Maserati brand. As a result, we are targeting to achieve a sustainable double-digit adjusted operating income margin in the midterm. We believe that this will make us a market leader in profitability in the provision of electrified mobility to customers on a global basis. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, Richard. So now you should have a clear picture of the EV strategy. We've looked under the hood. You saw the figures, 30 billion euros puts Stellantis in a leading position in the industry, committed to deliver double-digit profitability with well-positioned offers in the US and Europe and efficiency at the core. And if you have any questions, the Q&A session is coming up right after the next session. So please welcome back the CEO of Stellantis, Carlos Tavares, for the final words of today's presentation.